Okay, so now we're going to consider how to draw a isosceles right triangle using the turtle. This triangle is isosceles because these two sides are the same length, and it's a right triangle because we have a right angle right here. Okay. Let's put our turtle right over here. And for now, I'm not going to actually draw anything on the screen. I just want to see if I can get the turtle to follow the path of this edge. So I happen to know this particular triangle is 100 steps on this side and 100 on this side. So the start is easy. I can just say forward 100, and that takes me up to the corner. Now I want to figure out how much of a turn I have to make here. Well, let's consider for a minute how we make a right-angled isosceles triangle. If we look at this square, we can see that this triangle is made by starting with a square and drawing the diagonal. So this diagonal cuts this angle right in half, doesn't it? We know that each corner of the square is 90 degrees. So if we cut that 90 degrees in half, we have 45 degrees right here. Okay. So we know that this angle is 45 degrees. How much of a turn do we have to make? How much of a turn does the turtle have to make? Let's look here at the turn, okay? Now, in general, when we're turning a corner, you see how we're still facing in that direction. This entire angle, if we take the blue corner of the triangle together with this whole sector, is 180 degrees. And we know that this little blue part here, this little angle, is 45 degrees. So the total amount of turn, the angle in this whole sector here, is 180 minus 45, or 135 degrees. So let's turn right 135 degrees and see how that looks. Okay, that looks about right. Now we have to figure out the length of this line right here. And that's a little bit trickier. Let's consider for a minute, what we're going to have to look at is, we're going to start with two squares here. And think for a minute about the area of squares, and then it'll be clear why in a minute why we have to worry about the areas. But we said this is 100 steps. Actually, let's make up our own unit. We'll say this is one hectostep. Okay, a hectometer is 100 meters. A hectostep is 100 steps. So this is one hectostep. So this square is 1 by 1. So if each side is 1, then the area of the square as a whole is 1 square hectostep. And these two squares make up 2 square hectosteps. Now let's rearrange these pieces for a minute. Okay, we know the area of this square is 2 hectosteps because the area of this is 1 hectostep. The area of the square is 1 hectostep squared. So this has to be 2 hectosteps squared. So what does that mean about the length of this line? The length of this line times the length of this line is 2 hectosteps. So that means that one of these lines is the square root of 2 hectosteps. And since a hectostep is 100 steps, that means we want to go forward 100 times the square root of 2. So watch this turtle. When I hit return and we go forward, we should go all the way to the other corner. Let's see. Yes, that worked. Okay. So now let's see. Let's put our original triangle back in place. And now we want to figure out how much of a turn we need to make on this side. Remember, we turned 135 degrees here. Let's take a look at that turn. Well, this is also 45 degrees. So the turn we need to make here is also 180 minus 45, or 135 degrees. So let's go right 135. That looks right. And now we knew that this was 100 steps before. We went 100 steps this time. This, when we went from here to here, we went 100 steps. This is also 100 steps. And finally, just to get ourselves back to our initial state, to our starting position, I'm going to go right 90. And that draws it. So let's just double check. We'll move this guy down here, and we'll put the pen down. And now I'll just back up and walk through all the steps we took before. We went forward 100, right 135, forward 100 times the square root of 2, right 135, forward 100, and right 90. And that's how you make an isosceles right triangle.